Hello, welcome back to my channel. It's been quite a while, how have you been? In this video, I want to discuss a new Arduino board that just recently came out, the Arduino Nano Every. The Every is a new version of the classical Arduino Nano that everyone knows and loves. It has the same physical size and pin mapping, but instead of the old ATmega32 8P as a microcontroller, this one sports the 8-bit AVR0 series ATmega4809, which is a much more modern and advanced microcontroller. And I had great hopes for this one, but as you'll see, not all of them came true. First, let's talk about clock speed. The box says that the Nano Every runs at 20 MHz. Now, there's no crystal or oscillator component on the board, but I know that the ATmega4809 has an internal oscillator that can run at 20 MHz, so that made sense. However, something raised my suspicion, and I decided to look further into it. First, I wrote a little program that made the microcontroller output its own system clock to its clock out pin. This pin is not connected to any of the regular Arduino pins, actually on the Every it's not connected to anything at all, but I still managed to touch it with an oscilloscope probe, and this is what I got, a definite 16 MHz signal. If you want further proof, you can take a look at the oscillator configuration fuse of the ATmega4809. Its last two bits, frequency select, tell whether it's tuned to 16 MHz, value is 1, or to 20 MHz, value is 2. Run this sketch yourself and see that it is indeed 1. And remember, this is a fuse that cannot be changed by R code or the bootloader, only through direct programming with an external programmer. The interesting part is that time-dependent Arduino functions, such as delay or setting the serial baud rate, work just fine, meaning that the source code expects the Every to run at 16 MHz and not at 20 MHz as advertised. That could still be okay in terms of backwards compatibility and such, however, remember that internal oscillators are not as stable and accurate as external crystals and can be easily 1% off or even more from the actual real-world time. That's about a quarter hour every day. Now, let's talk about power. Here we have some actual good news. The main voltage regulator for 5 volts is the MPM3610, whose input range is 6 up to 21 volts and can deliver up to 1.2 amps. The 3.3 volt regulator has also been significantly upgraded compared to the classical Nano and can now provide up to 600 milliamps. Of course, you'd still want to stay away from these extremes in your projects. Next on our list is serial, or more accurately, UART communication. The ATmega4809 has 4 UART modules in hardware, numbered 0, 1, 2, and 3. Out of these, 2 are readily available on the Arduino Nano Every. Module number 3 is assigned to the default serial object. This goes through the onboard ATSAMD11 microcontroller and through the USB cable to the PC. In other words, this is the serial you talk with through the serial monitor. Module number 1, however, is serial 1, and that's the one that's connected to physical pins 0 and 1 of the Arduino board. This is very good actually, as long as you remember it's different from the way it was on the original Nano. Advanced users may want to utilize the remaining 2 UART modules. They are not defined in Arduino, so you'll have to set them up yourself, but luckily, their TX and RX pins are available. For module number 0, they would be pins 2 and 7 respectively. For module number 2, these are pins 6 and 3, but they are not the default pins for this module, and you'll have to set up the internal port multiplexer to the alternate pins. Again, this is advanced stuff, and we won't cover it here, just remember that the option to have 4 UARTs does exist. Digital and analog are a sore spot in this board. The designers practically painted themselves into a corner by sticking to the old Arduino Nano conventions. Because of this, 13 perfectly good I/O pins of the ATmega4809 aren't connected to anything and are totally wasted. The Nano Every has 8 analog inputs designated A0 through A7, and following the conventions, A4 and A5 also have the alternate function of I2C communication. This puzzled me because, looking at the ATmega4809 datasheet, there is no pin in it that can serve both as an analog input and as an I2C master. As it turns out, to allow this double functionality of A4 and A5, the designers basically short-circuited the 2 pairs of pins, port A pin 2 with port F pin 2 and port A pin 3 with F3. This hack certainly works, But if one day you play around with the internal registers and forget the subtlety, issues and even smoke will arise. Looking again at the box, we see that there are only 5 PWM output pins. This is certainly not the same as in the old Nano, or the Arduino Uno for that matter, which has 6. This happened because pins 9 and 11 share the same PWM resource in the ATmega4809, so they can't both work. If you try to analog write to pin 11, you won't get the signal you expect. Was there a better way to arrange the pins and avoid this problem? I didn't go over all the options yet, but I suspect there isn't. So much for backwards compatibility then. Arduino made a big fuss about the Every being particularly suitable for PCBs. It has no components on the bottom, and has castellations on the sides for easy soldering to the PCB. Unfortunately, all the pin numbers and names are at the bottom. So if you're not soldering it to a custom PCB, just play around with a breadboard, you won't be able to see them. Despite everything I said so far, the voltage regulators are not the only good things about the Arduino Nano Every. First of all, obviously, is the price. An original Nano Every board costs less than half of a Nano, excluding taxes and shipping. That is really impressive. Second, the ATmega4809 has 48 kilobytes of flash, hence its name, which is 50% more than the Nano, and 6 kilobytes of RAM, which is a fantastic 200% increase. Unfortunately, these benefits come at a price of a 75% decrease in EEP ROM, to merely 256 bytes. Naturally, we can't expect all the Arduino libraries out there to support this new board with the different architecture of its microcontroller. I was happy to discover that the essential common ones do seem to work. Here you can see Adafruit's NeoPixel strand test working out of the box, so to speak, with the Nano Every. So, in conclusion, should you buy an Arduino Nano Every? Well, no. If you're an absolute beginner, you'd be better off with the tried and true Nano and the existing resources for it. If you're more advanced and you want to play around with all the cool features of the ATmega4809 itself, it would make more sense to get one of the evaluation boards offered by Microchip, or even spin one yourself like I did. There's only a narrow range of applications where it would really make sense to get a Nano Every and not use the other options out there. Of course, if you just like new stuff and or want to support Arduino, knock yourself out. As usual, if you found this video helpful, please like, share, subscribe, tweet, support, comment, watch again, clap your hands, retweet, click everything on the screen, pay your taxes, and love thy neighbor. Thank you for watching.